For local news from Clarke County, Alabama, subscribe to the ClarkeCountyDemocrat.com for just 99 cents with coupon code PODCAST. Pig Squeal Show and Sale this Saturday in Fulton. The popular 4-H Pig Squeal program wasn't canceled last year due to the coronavirus pandemic. Kids still raised their pigs and learned while doing so, but the popular show and auction event was a casualty to the pandemic. It wasn't held in an effort to avoid a large gathering of people. However, the pigs were still sold and the program was deemed a success. The show and sale are back on to culminate the 2021 program. It will be held in the usual place, just off Highway 178 in Fulton this Saturday, April 24th. The show is at 11 a.m. and the auction will start around 1 p.m. Wendy Paget of the Clarke County Extension Service Office oversees local 4-H activities. "This is our biggest year ever, but we have said that almost every year since we started Pig Squeal in 2014, she laughed. "This year there are 31 young pig farmers. Each received two pigs in January to raise. There were 26 participants last year." She remembered the circumstances that led to the program starting back in 2014. Paget and her husband, Glenn, a local attorney, have a literal menagerie of animals at their home. They were raising pigs in 2014 and Wendy took in the runt of the litter to try and help it along. She took it to an after-school program where she was working for a sort of show and tell. "All the kids were so excited. I want one, so many of them said," she explained. The 4-H chick chain, the raising of chickens, had started earlier and had sparked a young interest in animals. She took the pig to other places and the comments from the youngsters were the same. They were all enthralled with the critter. Back at the Extension Alabama office, she went to County H Extension Agent Kevin Tucker. "Kevin, I think a lot of kids are interested in pigs and I think we could do a program," she told him. He looked at her and said, "What?" Tucker did some investigating and came back and told her that a pig program was going to be much more expensive than the chicken program. "But if you can get 10 or 12 kids interested, we'll try it," he told her. "We had 17 to sign up that first year," Paget beamed. Other than a dip 1 or 2 years, participation has grown steadily every year since. "Some students enjoy the program so much they have participated every year." Paget mentioned Shaylin Merida as an example of a long-time participant. "She started with us when we started 8 years ago," she said. Luke Stevens is another long-time participant. He is applying for a 4-H Senior Achievement Award this year. The students learn to keep records about health and medical issues, finances. The students, or usually their parents, have to pay for their own hog feed and other expenses, nutrition matters, and the discipline and responsibility of having to see after and take care of something for several weeks. Students learn at the outset of the program that the pigs aren't pets. They are being raised to be slaughtered or sold for slaughter in order to put the bacon on the table, so to speak. Students have to make sure their hogs' pens are safe and secure, and they have to make sure they are healthy. They have to be fed, but it isn't as simple as opening a bag and pouring out the feed. There is an optimum weight the animals should be going to market. You don't want them underweight for sure, but there is such a thing as being overweight, too, Paget said. The students and their parents agree to be responsible for all finances for raising their pigs. The families can either opt to keep one or both hogs for their own freezer, or they can let them be sold at the Pig Squeal auction. One dad of a new pig farmer told his son, "You're going to have to do this for at least 3 more years so we can at least pay for this pen." Paget said it was a very nice pen. Usually, at least one hog is sold. The proceeds help defray some of the expenses. Until last year, and now again this year, spirited auctions with fierce bidding is the way the hogs are sold. Last year's sales were farmed out and done by phone, but it wasn't nearly as exciting as a live auction. Some buyers buy the hogs for their own freezers. Others buy and give the meat away. They want to help others, but to help the program, too. Processors will be at the sale to pick up the hogs. Packaged meats are delivered back to the Grove Hill office for pickup by buyers. "You can't beat the taste and quality of these homegrown hogs," Paget said. Paget and Tucker encourage everyone to come to Fulton Saturday for a few hours of fun and to support the hard-working youth. The mask mandate has been lifted, but they are still encouraged in large groups. Paget said there will be hand sanitizer stations and she urged people to observe social distancing and other safe practices. Susie Q's Sawmill Cafe will be set up selling sandwiches and other concessions during the midday event. For more information, call Wendy Paget, 251-533-7507, or Kevin Tucker, 334-534-2539.